Have new details in the murder case of local realtor Mary Beth San Juan. The Honolulu medical examiner confirms she was stabbed multiple times before being wrapped in carpet and left dead in her driveway. HPD says after this ATM video was aired on our news last night, they received several calls from people with information. And another break in the case came last night. Breanne Randall has details you'll only see on KHON2. Breanne?
Joe, we know Mary Beth's car was left on Kalakaua Avenue by Kapiolani Park bandstand. Just walking distance from there is now a new crime scene where her wallet was found near a dumpster.
The murder investigation of Mary Beth San Juan is heating up after a shocking discovery overnight. Honolulu police surrounded the Waikiki Beachside Hostel after a man digging through trash near the hostel's dumpster came across a key piece of evidence.
What did you find last night?
I found the Punahou murder victim's wallet. It was tied up in an ABC bag.
The man didn't want to reveal his identity. Police sources confirmed to KHON2 the wallet is Mary Beth San Juan's.
How did you know?
At first I didn't, but I checked after to see if her credit cards were current. And when going through it, the manager at the hostel pulled out a card, and it was a real estate card, and it looked just like the lady that was the Punahou murder victim.
We know Mary Beth's car was left on Kalakaua Avenue sometime between early Monday morning to midday Tuesday after it was driven to an ATM to grab cash out of her bank account. Walking distance from there is where her wallet was found on Lemon Road.
It was tied up in an ABC bag, so I opened it up to see what it was, and it turned out to be a nice wallet.
He says the wallet had credit cards but no cash, only loose change, and was in an ABC bag stuffed into a larger black garbage bag.
The rubbish came out from the hostel. It piled up on a sidewalk. I put it in there. I go through it.
Local residents can't get a room at the hostel unless they have proof of travel or a plane ticket. Honolulu police spent several hours sifting through the dumpster's trash for more clues. Nearby building managers say police have also requested to see their surveillance videos showing the street.
I hope they catch them. I hope they got them on video.
Mary Beth's sisters have flown into town, and we spoke to them and her ex-husband today. They tell us they aren't ready to talk about what happened. Breanne Randall, KHON 2 News.